Today, we are going to look at a BodyViz Brain Builder about the teeth and malocclusion. Our teeth are more than just tools for chewing, they shape our smiles and influence our speech. In this Brain Builder, we will explore the anatomy and significance of teeth. We'll break down the challenges posed by teeth misalignment, the different types of malocclusions, and the most effective forms of treatment. Properly positioned teeth should slightly overlap, with upper molars fitting into the grooves of the lower ones. This alignment ensures safe speaking and chewing, preventing accidental bites to the cheeks, lips, and tongue. The tooth consists of three main sections: the crown, which is visible above the gum line, the root, embedded in the bony sockets of the jaw, and the neck, which demarcates the crown and the root. Delving deeper into its structure, the primary substance of a tooth is the dentin, a layer similar to bone but devoid of living cells. Living cells reside within the tooth's pulp cavity and help maintain the dentin. The root's dentin is shielded by a layer of cement, anchoring the tooth firmly into the jaw's socket. Finally, the crown's dentin is coated by enamel, the hardest material produced by the human body. As we mature, we develop two distinct sets of teeth. The initial set, known as deciduous or baby teeth, usually emerge around 6 months, completing their appearance by age 2. This set comprises 20 teeth in total, 4 molars, 2 canines, and 4 incisors in both the mandible and the maxilla. The deciduous teeth of the mandible usually erupt before their counterparts in the maxillae. The central incisors are typically the first to emerge between 6 to 8 months. The lateral incisors break through around 8 to 10 months. By the first year, the first molars make their appearance, canines at 18 months, and by the age of 2, the second molars have erupted. Around the age of 6, the replacement of deciduous teeth with permanent teeth begins. In total, we have 32 permanent teeth, with 16 in the mandible and 16 in the maxillae. Similar to the pattern observed with deciduous teeth, the permanent teeth in the mandible generally emerge before their counterparts in the maxillae. The timeline for their emergence is as follows. The first molars erupt at around 6 years, followed by the central incisors at 7 years. The lateral incisors appear by 8 years, succeeded by their first premolars at 9 and second premolars at 10. By 11, the canines emerge, the second molars by 12, and the third molars, often referred to as wisdom teeth, make their debut anywhere between 17 to 30 years. Malocclusion, or a bad bite, arises when a person's upper and lower teeth do not correctly align upon closing of the mouth. There are 3 classifications of malocclusion. In class 1, the bite is normal. However, the teeth of the maxillae overlap the teeth of the mandible more than usual. In class 2 malocclusion, or an overbite, the teeth of the maxillae severely overlap the teeth of the mandible. Finally, in class 3 malocclusions, termed underbites, the jaw protrudes forward, causing the teeth of the mandible to overlap the teeth of the maxillae. Next, we will look at the causes, symptoms, and treatments for malocclusions, and then give a patient example. While there are a myriad of possible causes, for many, it's the result of teeth being oversized for their mouth, leading to overcrowding and subsequently altering the alignment between the mandible and maxilla. Early tooth loss can also cause neighboring teeth to shift into the vacant space. Childhood habits, like thumb sucking, can also influence tooth positioning, and, while uncommon, certain genetic conditions might cause misalignment between the mandible and the maxilla. Unaddressed malocclusions present several complications. Not only can they lead to temporomandibular joint disorders, TMJ, or speech impediments such as lisping, but malocclusions can result in significant discomfort during biting or chewing. Over time, untreated malocclusions can comprise oral health, elevating the risk for cavities and gum disease. Beyond the physical implications, severe unresolved malocclusions can impact one's self-esteem and mental well-being. Malocclusion is typically treated using braces, which gradually realign teeth over time. This realignment induces remodeling of the mandible, maxillae, and tooth sockets, ensuring teeth stay in their new positions. In cases of severe overcrowding, oral surgery might be necessary to remove certain teeth, and this is often followed by braces to ensure proper alignment of the remaining teeth. For For unique situations, like inherited malocclusions, modifications to the mandible's bone might be needed. Effective treatment requires the patient's patience, coupled with the expertise of an orthodontist or an oral surgeon. Finally, let's take a look at a patient example. You receive your patient's file and take a look. Age, 10. Sex, female. Chief complaints, difficulty speaking and lisp. Jaw pain while eating and an overbite. You invite the patient into your office for an examination. As your patient has a more extreme overbite, you diagnose a class 2 malocclusion. To correct a class 2 malocclusion, your patient will get orthodontic treatment in the form of braces. Additionally, headgear is recommended for a couple hours every day to apply pressure to the teeth in the maxilla to push them back into position. Undergoing braces and headgear treatment is a significant commitment, typically lasting about 3 years. It's crucial to emphasize the importance of twice daily brushing, flossing, and maintaining overall dental hygiene with your patient. With dedication and consistent care, they'll soon be flashing a brilliant set of pearly whites. This is a classic example of malocclusion. Thank you for watching this Brain Builder video. Please like and subscribe to our BodyViz channel, or if you are new at BodyViz, check out our other anatomy resources and schedule a demo at bodyviz.com.